The Genoese lived in Gibraltar well before the British. The connection goes back to medieval times. For it was the Genoese merchants and shipowners that were responsible for most of the trade between Muslim Spain and Morocco. Yet many of these Genoese merchants married Spanish women. And as a result, the traditions and language began to dissolve. But there was a nucleus of Genoese settlers who remained true to their heritage, and these resided in Catalan Bay. The first lived in caves and appeared seasonally, coming to Gibraltar to fish, yet always returning home to Genoa, making the perilous journey in their open-top fishing boats. Yet it was after the British capture when many chose to make it their home. And by 1777, half of the population were Genoese. The most affluent section of the community played an important role in supplying the garrison. This created wealth and stature, and they shaped the way that Gibraltarian society was to develop. They formed what could be termed as Main Street society. As their influence strengthened, they became the backbone of the civilian population, and Gibraltar was a trilingual society. In Catalan Bay, great change was also afoot. Many of the Genoese fishermen, whom had previously journeyed to and fro, had decided to stay, bringing their families with them. Their links to Genoa were strong, and thus traditions were maintained and celebrated. In fact, it is only as recent as the 1980s that Catalan Bay lost the last of its Genoese speakers. Genoa is a place that grows upon you every day. It abounds in the strangest contrasts. Things that are picturesque, ugly, mean, magnificent, delightful, and offensive break upon the view at every turn. This is how Charles Dickens described Genoa in 1844, and his description still fits today.
This is the Piazza de Ferrari, a well-known name in Gib, and a landmark here in Genoa. And I happened to have stumbled across an artisan market. Now, you know how I like to try my food. Behind me, we've got the best stall, which is something traditional to Genoa, and also a little stall that I want to stop at right here, where they sell focaccia, and that is typical of the Ligurian region.
It's a street food cooked morning till night, enticing you to stop at one of the multitude of bakeries found in this city.
I can spot some farinata in the oven, which is obviously their version of our calentita. They've got a whole production line set up here. They're actually making it all on the premises, right in the middle of this beautiful piazza.
Where are you from?
I am from Gibraltar.
Gibraltar?
Yes.
Very nice.
And we are here in Genoa because a lot of people, a lot of immigrants from Genoa came to live in Gibraltar in the late 1780s.
Late 1780s.
Yeah, and my family also came from Genoa. Ah. So there's a lot of Gibraltarians, who, their ancestors were from here. A lot of fishermen. We have a little bay, a beach called La Caleta. And it's a fishing village, and their boats, their fishing boats, they're all in the Genoese style. And we have this at home. But we call this, we have farinata. The same, but we call it calentita.
Calentita, it's strange.
Could I try some farinata, please, and focaccia? They look absolutely delicious. And it's way past my lunchtime, so I'm tempted to try them all. Grazie. You know what I'm like? I'm just going to use my fingers and dive right in. Right, this is the farinata, which is like a calentita. Really crispy on the top. I have to say, I think the Genoese certainly beat us on that one. Okay, now this is the famous focaccia. Wow. That is absolutely delicious. It's really light, really tasty. It's a strong goat's cheese, which works really well with the saltiness of the focaccia, and you can just taste the olive oil coming through. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm just gonna eat a little bit more.
The layout of Genoa's old town reflects its medieval politics, and the maze of alleyways was the battleground of long-running feuds between the Doria, Spinola, Grimaldi, and Fieschi families.
These are the St. Andrew Towers that were built to defend the Soprana Gate. Now, the Soprana Gate was one of the main entrances to the city. Unfortunately, they're pretty much all that's left of the original medieval walls. They were built in the 1100s, and towards the end, this bit in particular, were completed in just under 53 days. And that was due to a massive effort by the entire population. They knew that Emperor Barbarossa was on his way, and they would do anything to defend the city. Now, inscribed on the archway in between the two towers is these beautiful words, and I think they sum up Genoa, its ethos, and the strength of the people perfectly. So if you bear with me, I'm just going to read them to you.
I am guarded by soldiers, surrounded by magnificent walls, and with my valor, I cast away enemies' darts. If you bring peace, you're well matched to these ports. If you seek war, sad and beat, you will retreat. The south and the west, the north and the east know upon which enormous battle thrills I, Genoa, have prevailed.
I found myself a little oasis of calm. It's the St. Andrew's Cloister in between the St. Andrew Towers and Christopher Columbus' supposed home. I say supposed because there was not much known about him, an enigma which he himself perpetrated. I think he enjoyed shrouding himself in mystery. He never once said told anyone who his parents were. Even his birth date is something that's in dispute. But one thing is certain, he was a cartographer, a navigator, and a mariner of heroic proportions.
However, when Columbus approached the Genoese bankers to finance his voyages, no one was interested, so he turned to Spain for backing.
Ciao.
Hello.
Hi.
The sign caught my attention. It says you've been open since 1780.
1780, the company was founded. The shop was opened in 1814, so this one has 200 years. You should try the cinnamon. You want to try it?
Yeah, I've never tried. I love cinnamon.
Okay.
And that's one I haven't tried before. I've tried
this one.
Those are very traditionally, wow.
It's traditional for Genoa to have this one. Like. For a good omer at home, for the neighbors, for the friends, for the family. Is it good?
This is very good.
Yes.
I'm a big cinnamon fan. I drink cinnamon tea. And the only ones I've tried really are the almonds, which you get in for wedding favors.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, we call it bomboniere for the weddings. We use almonds with sugar. Sometimes you also can use this, but this is one typical.
So people have those that is at home? They'll have a bowl at home?
In the past, yes.
In the past.
You know, if you buy the fruit, you have to eat in 1 week or a few days. But if you candy the fruit, you can keep for 2-3 months. So the sailormen bring the fruit with them so they could have fruits for the travel, the trip a month, I mean.
Right, so that they were prepared here and then perhaps sent out with sailors on the way out, or mariners. They used to take their fruit with them out to sea. Do fishermen still take them out?
No.
Not anymore.
Too expensive now. I really, really like the fig, but I don't know if you like
it. That is exactly what I was going to ask
for. Okay, you want to try one?
If I could try a fig, because, gosh, this is big.
Is it big? Yeah, but
no,
it's
good. I shall try.
Okay,
I'm going to go. This looks amazing.
What do you think?
That is really good fig. Wow. Because sometimes with fig, unless you get them very, very sweet, that they aren't nice. A fig is to be nice sweet, but this, you're guaranteed sweetness all the time.
Yeah, exactly.
I think I'll have to have a rose.
Rose?
A rose, this is rose, real rose petal.
On the top, yes.
With a dark chocolate
and rose inside. Sugar, fondant.
They're absolutely beautiful, aren't they? They really are works of art. This is like a jewellery shop for me.
Yeah,
I get more excited about this than jewellery. Wow.
It's a good match, you know what I mean?
It's a very good match. I love Turkish delight. And rose Turkish delight is my favorite. So I think the rose with them, it's such a scented, perfumed flavor, but it works so nicely with the dark chocolate.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay. My family will never forgive me unless I take something home.
Abbronzate tutte chiazze, pelli rosse un po' paonazze, son le ragazze che prendono il sole. Ma ce n'è una che prende la luna.
So he's saying that they dip the focaccia in the cappuccino.
Yeah.
And write a cappuccino in the morning only.
And then during the day, coffee.
And during the day, espresso, without milk.
Espresso. Yeah.
Okay. As you can see, I'm sat here at Café Latino. I couldn't resist. And this is Davide and Glenda, who are now going to take me on a bit of a tour around the old town. And more importantly, they're going to take me to see the magnificent Il Duomo. So next drink should be a beer. Is a beer okay?
Yeah.
Tintarella di Luna.
Genoa's heart is its port. But Genoa's soul can be discovered amidst the warren of alleyways that makes up its medieval center. The dirty streets and graffiti-ridden walls houses a district brimming with zest and vibrancy. It manages to repel and attract in equal measures. Yet it does so unashamedly, and it's this raw, bawdy earthiness that makes it a place like no other.
Davide, this is the famous Il Duomo.
La chiesa, diciamo, la cattedrale importante.
The main cathedral. This is where the cardinal is.
Yeah.
I love that this is black and white.
Black
is it marble?
Il nero è
ardesia.
Ardesia.
Unfortunately, Il Duomo was closed for the night, but I would return. My day gets off to an early start at the rather grand offices of the Genoese Film Commission. Matteo has promised to help.
In La Caleta, Catalan Bay in Gibraltar, which is a fishing village where most of the immigrants there were Genoese. So most of the population of Catalan Bay are Genoese. And in fact, some of them still have relatives here, which I'm going to go visit. But it wasn't until the late 1970s, 1980s, that they stopped talking Genoese. They still were talking Genoese
more like,
then.
Me too, I don't talk in Genoese. I understand everything, but I don't talk. My sister talk in Genoese, which is 8 years more.
That's such a pity.
I know.
It's
now
the
identity, I know.
It's the identity, not just you, but for everyone in Genoa.
Yeah,
schools,
I know, but
and it's
I know.
Not encouraged.
No,
it's losing
not
the identity, yeah?
I know.
Okay, so we need to confirm the date with Mr. Panizza.
Yeah.
And he's all right with us filming in his kitchen, in his house?
Yeah, it's not his house. It's a place like a house with the cook and he show you as he prepare the pesto.
Having finalized some filming arrangements with the Genoese Film Commission, I was free to visit Bocadase. Bocadase is a tiny fishing village that has been enveloped by the sprawling tentacles of the ever-growing city. But it still retains its charm and is a must-see. It's Bocadase more than any other place that reminds me of Catalan Bay. It retains that tranquil feel of times gone by where neighbors are so much more like family. All is irrelevant except for the catch of the day.
Cerveza?
Birra, grazie.
Eccoci.
Grazie. Wow. Zucchini, carrots in here. We've got, I don't know if you can see, it looks amazing.
Squid.
We've got tiny little squids, calamare. Vocherone.
We began 1 year ago with the IT Turismo, the possibility to make a taste. Thank you. Our fish for people and
calamar, nice.
We go in school too.
To teach the children how to.
How we work with a small boat and the kind of net we use. My grandma and cook every kind of fish. Now it's impossible found in family and even in restaurant. Only in place like this, where in a restaurant when I sell my fish. They buy only 1, 2, 3, 4 kinds only. But every fish is good to eat.
Luca works for a fishing cooperative based in Bocadase. They don't sell their catch. Instead, they work together pulling their resources and supplying a restaurant owned by themselves. Their monthly wage depends on the success of the restaurant. And going by the quality of the fish I've tasted, I'd guess they're onto a winning formula.
Tuo fa l'americano, americano, americano. Sienta me chi don fa fan.
Ciao.
Ciao.
Hello, I've been told, I had it recommended.
by a friend that this is the best gelateria in the whole of Genoa.
This is the best.
This is the best. Well, we should put that to the test.
This is a cream with nuts inside.
Cream with nuts.
You like it?
Wow.
We have another thing.
I like it a lot.
Which is special for Genoa. It's called panera.
Panera. And
the
what's panera?
The taste is like a coffee.
A coffee,
but
okay.
It's just a little bit smoothie. Creamy. But if you have to try, if you like chocolate, you have to try our dark chocolate.
Wow, just look at the color on that. Okay, I'm really excited.
This is very, very good. I told you. It's very, very good.
That is amazing.
Dark chocolate.
This is incredible. Thank you ever so much.
You're welcome. And have a nice day.
I'll give you this here.
Yes, of course.
Thank you.
Have a nice day.
Bye.
See you.
Very subtle flavors. And the nuts are, I know, they're always a bit like crocanti. Absolutely delicious. I'm leaving the chocolate for last because that's my favorite. This one I couldn't resist. A turrón de pistacho. Oh my God. I want to do a food dance. It's lemony, the pistachio is crispy. I've never had anything like this before. I can't stop. Okay, chocolate, dark chocolate, one of my favorite things in the world. And dark chocolate ice cream is up there. Oh my God, this is lavish indulgence at its best. It's dark, it's strong, it's an explosion of flavor in your mouth. There's a massive depth to the taste. It's really, really smooth. It takes over. But it doesn't have that, you know, sometimes with dark chocolate, it's got that bitter aftertaste, that powdery taste. That's not there. This is absolutely divine.
Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the national anthem of Italy.
It's the Euro Cup and Italy has drawn Spain. No need to guess whom I'm supporting. Tensions are high, for in their last encounter, Spain thrashed Italy 4-0 in the final. This match is more than just football. It's a matter of honor, justice, and punishment.
Salute. Grazie. Forza Italia.
Siempre.
Sempre.
Renzi in movimento, cercato Pelé, e De Gea la toglie dalla porta, prima clamorosa palla gol per Pelé, secondo palo c'è Parolo, Florenzi prova a metterla proprio lì, colpo di testa centrale, Zaccariglio, palo, un fuori gioco, ed è, facci cantare. Parolo. Pelé con il tacco a destra. È più veloce di Piquet.
Italiano, italiano.
Ma questa se l'è mangiata, direi. Doveva chiuderla. Insigne lontano De Gea ancora. Con sicurezza. Centrale. Barzagli prova a saltare all'indietro. Pallone Piquet. Buffon. Buffon.
Two glorious goals ensure Italy's victory and a night of celebrations. My adventures in Genoa are far from over. This city has so much to offer, and I have so much to discover.